Hello, welcome. My name is Xander. This is the setup guide for the Django 4.x ORM Mastery course, Codebase-0. The likelihood is that you've come to this tutorial to learn how to set up the code base in preparation to complete one of the tutorials in this course. If you haven't, you now know the purpose of this tutorial. It is a setup guide that supports other tutorials in this course. To get the Codebase started, which is a Django application, the first thing you need to do is have a look in the video description. There should be a link to some code, to a code repository, a GitHub code repository. Go ahead and download that. Once you've downloaded the Codebase, you'll need to extract it, put it into a folder, and then open that up in Visual Studio Code. And that's exactly where we're going to start this setup guide. Just before we start, two things here. There is an additional tutorial called Codebase-0 Step-by-Step. That tutorial will take you from absolutely nothing to a Django application. We go through the process of creating a virtual environment and then also a Django application. So just check out the links in the video description. You'll find that link. The final thing, of course, is just to remind you about the Django 4.x ORM Mastery course, which you can purchase on Udemy. It is a complete structured learning experience, which will continue to develop. So please check out the course if that's something you're interested in. Again, you'll find the link to the course in the video description. Once you've gone through those steps, you should have Visual Studio Code open. You can see that I made a folder called Project and I placed all of those files inside of that project folder that I've downloaded. Right, so now we've done that, let's go to view here, and then let's open the terminal. We can use the shortcut. And the first thing we need to do is build a new virtual environment. So let's use Python, and then let's tell it to create a new virtual environment. The folder is going to be called VEMB, so you can call it whatever you like. So that will create a new virtual environment, and then we need to activate it. So here on the Mac, I've just forgotten, here on the Mac, yep, we type in VEMB, bin, and then activate, go on. Oh no, it's like I haven't done this a million times. Right, so source VEMB, and then bin, and then activate. There we go. Right, so we've activated. If you're on the Windows machine, you're going to need to type in VEMB, backslash, and then script, and then activate. So if you're on Windows, activate. There we go. So if you're on Windows, you need to type that in. So where you should be now is you should have the virtual environment prompt here at the start of the terminal line. And now we're ready to go. All the requirements that we need to get this project started are here in the requirements.txt. So the reality is here that we only need Django installed. So we could just pip install Django, but for further reference, you might find that there are multiple applications that are required, libraries, that are required in order to actually get this application started. So let's go ahead and say pip install, and we'll use the R flag and then requirements.txt here. So I press tab after I've typed a few letters and it finds the file associated to those letters. If there's more than one, it won't do that, so you have to type in a few more letters. Right, so I'll go ahead and install that, and you can see that's going to download and install all those dependencies, and we're ready to go. So with that done, we should now be able to Python 3 manage.py and then run server, and that should run successfully. And there we go. Just some additional information for those who need it. So I'll just close that, Control C. You'll see that we have the core folder. So this represents our main project folder. This is where the settings file is found. And you can see we have the inventory application. So we're going to be working within the inventory application. So we do need to, in the core, go to settings, and we have already activated or made that inventory application part of our main core application by adding it here in the installed apps. So now we're ready to get started in this section of the course.